I am also very proud to let you know that the respected president of Turkey has kindly managed, in spite of his day's program, he was abroad, and come join us. Professor Hasan Mandal, indeed, is a big friend of fundamental science and supporter of our institute. He's also a main organizer of this event today. Please let us thank and welcome very warmly the respected president of TÜBİTAK for coming and joining us. And to begin.
So, good evening. So, distinguished scientists, lecturers, dear colleagues, ladies and gentlemen. So, it's a great pleasure for me to be, I mean, at least to join to the closing session, and I thank very much to Eugene. I mean, to enjoy, I mean, I am a material scientist, but more on the technology part, but I enjoyed very much from the lecture, and I missed the others. I normally plan to be, I mean, attend the hall, but in the last moment, I mean, we have been meeting in the commission in Brussels on whole day, on starting from Thursday evening and Friday whole day. And therefore, I only able to join to the closing session. And Ali Akram Hoca, I mean, I thank him very much. I mean, I know that this organization of this type of events is not an easy to bring to all the, I mean, scientists, students, lecturers. I mean, not only in Turkey, around the globe, to come in here and bring all of us to move and to work together, and I am saying more than the collaboration, to co-creation is one of the key parameters for the future. Yes, indeed, I have been. I have been honored to be as one of the organizers. But I mean, I personally only help him in maybe very little. I mean, he's the leader of this event, so I think one more. Very much to him to organize this event. And before this, also, we during the summertime, I mean, some of you all already also joined. So there are two workshops, more on our new, young colleagues who would like to be work on this field, on basic science and natural sciences. As TÜBİTAK, I mean, at least for our Turkish colleagues and students, I mean, know very well, I mean, it is in the Scientific and Technological Research Council of Turkey since from 1963. So it's from the 56 years we are celebrating for our, formation of the TÜBİTAK. But we are more on the technology side, especially starting from year 2010 till, maybe still we are focused on more application and technology. But I am putting my all efforts to, everything starting from the basic science. Without the grant level, we cannot build up to the top. So therefore, this is the maybe third version of the, this institute, but now we are working very closely, very hard. And of course, with your help, that, we will move a better, not in terms of the awareness of the basic science, also, but we are working also how can we also link with the other institutes. So this is one of our challenge at TÜBİTAK, because so we have been well known with the different type of institutes. Link more industry, and especially for the defense side. Yes, we are. Not enough, but we are satisfied. And now we are moving on medicine and energy. But still, we are building up on technology. But all of us in this room, that we know that to create the technology, we need to with the science, we need the knowledge. So, as a closing, remarks, I'll give a kind of my view on this topic. I'm as I said, material scientist, but working on more on technology part. So I hope that it will help, because normally it's supposed to be, I'll give this presentation at the beginning, So I don't know how much it will help at the end, but still I'll keep my presentation to at least to share how me, myself, and Tubitak thinks about on this specific topic. Now I am in now hearing on teleportation, and when I'm checking the what are the, I mean, I am not an expert, I am only learner in this field, so when I checked what are the recent publications talk about, when we are talking about quantum mechanics, on both on storing, processing, and transferring, and I mean, one part, exactly what we have been heard as a lecture, and the other one is on quantum encryption keys. So this is, I think, one of the area, and match them how the Tubitak will do in future on these topics. Quantum internet, and the other one is, I am very much interested how the quantum computers will help to be new materials and drugs. So this is which we have a strong interest, and also quantum machine learning. And there are small groups in Tubitak, although we have been known as more technology provider, but there's a small group in Tubitak as well. We are working on quantum mechanics. And I mean, we are all around the globe, so I mean in Turkey and also from our colleagues coming from abroad to talk about the topics on this workshop on the areas which I thought that what are the agenda, but also some kind of challenges. For example, when I'm looking for very recent one, World Economic Forum 2019, the Global Risks Report, and so you can see the there are many challenges as global risks. And one of the topic on the base of the technology, on cyber attacks. So when we are moving to the quantum computing, how this will make our life is in one side is easier, in the other side is difficult. So in that case, again, the quantum proof encryption is one of the area which at least we are interested. So therefore the research is a main tool, for all of us. So how we are reshaping the for the future. And so this is a report, again, very recent report on the European Universities Association, how the transformation of the research and development and innovation processes. So one of the change is also what we are trying at Tubitak. So from linear to reiterative innovation. So what does it mean that? So as soon as when we produce the knowledge, so it doesn't stop there. I mean, okay, in one side as a scientist, yes, so this is a kind of an output generally in terms of the publications, and publications in good journals, but still doesn't stop. So which means that still continue, so which means that so till this knowledge can be usable, should be back, and so it is not a one way, it's not a linear, so it's a reversible type of situation. So in the past, yes, every scientist can do their own, but and I see this type of events, it bring this type of ecosystem that not only limited to the work on one side, but how we can transfer until become the useful knowledge. Other one is the systemic challenge-driven innovation. So which means that, in one side, we have all our disciplines, but the challenges is covering the more interdisciplinary approach. So this is again, in working on basic science and natural sciences, but also should be, we are thinking that how we can solve the problems in a systematic way. And one of the keywords which we are trying, rather than the collaboration, so how we can work on the co-creation. So from the university's part, for a recent report from the European University Association saying that, so moving from the nonlinear shared knowledge and co-creation in one part, and in the other side is that there are challenges, and that these challenges can be solved only by the systemic approach and by means of the interdisciplinary research. So this is again from the World Economic Forum report from China in last July. And it is talking about, so what are the emerging technologies for 2019? But moving before that, so there is a change of the trends. The change of the trends means that maybe still, especially in Turkey, we are talking about the sectors. I mean, the sector of automotive industry, textile industry, or electronic industry, whatever. But moving to the technologies, okay, it's not from the, I mean, the sectors are, because technologies can solve the problem in a different type of sectors. But more than this, so there's a mission type of orientation. So there are challenges, and this could be solved by the technologies, and this can develop the sectors. So this is also the kind of a new Horizon Europe mission approach for the which will be start in 2021. So there have been missions there, challenging missions. I mean, not the thematical areas. There are missions, and the technologies should expected to be solved, help, and the sectors will be developed. And within these 10 emerging technologies, which were mentioned during this meeting, I mean, I am sure that you maybe, I mean, get an impression more, but at least two of them, I mean, which I think that is very relevant with the quantum system. So disordered proteins as drug targets, and the other side, DNA data storage. So these are all type of areas, I mean, at least two, which cannot be solved with the classical way. And from the this global perspective to move to the more national one, so there are 11th plan development plan was just recently published, and there are in the five main pillars. And when if you see in here, I mean, maybe we cannot see the how the basic science and natural science can help. But if you go to the details, yeah, we can find to achieve these five pillars. So the science is the main type of keyword should be work on it. Yes, imports of R&D and innovation to reach into the vision. And some of the numbers for 2023. So of course, we need fund the more projects, R&D projects. So there will be as a target to increase the funding at least nearly two times from 0.96 of the GDP to the 1.8. Increasing the full-time equivalent researcher. But it's the first time there is a goal that the number of R&D personnel with PhD. So I think this is one of the achievement at least from the TÜBİTAK side. We asked not only named the amount, numbers of researchers, we are more interested on the PhD holders. So because when we are talking about science-oriented technology development and innovation, so we need to be more PhD holders. And these PhD holders, not only limited to the academia, not only limited to the research centers, but also including the industry. And from the other side, so this is a report from the Science Technology Innovation Policy Board of the presidency. So we have been working on 27 technologies, and we have been worked in a different type of way. We used to be in the past, we are working on the technologies as an input oriented, or even maybe kind of an output. But in that study, we have been worked on more impact on economically, societal, national security. But at the meantime, the feasibility, okay, in the seven headings, the academic knowledge accumulation, the private sector project competence, the research infrastructure, human resources, the financial, accessing the financial capital, and the state of the art of that relevant technology. And in here you can see this 27, and one of them is quantum technologies. Of course, not only limited, so others also can be linked. So we have been worked from our side. And so this is the, for the short period of time, short period of time means for the next 5 years. So how the, how we see the, this picture, I mean these technologies in for, in Turkey. So in one side in here, so this is the impact and this is the feasibility. So this is the area in short time maybe. And the area that part is in the medium term. So we, I mean, in still, I mean, it's maybe unfortunate, but still quantum technologies is not have enough awareness. So therefore, still from the impact part and the feasibility part, we cannot see, I mean, I normally want to see in there, but still we are struggling, challenging that, and as I said, because of the not enough awareness and also, okay, still maybe we are using the quantum technologies, maybe as a popular, but more than the popular, I think we should talk about the kind of an impact. So therefore, I found this meeting is very important. I mean, not only limited, I mean, so for this 3 or 4 days, definitely will come afterwards, and I'll show how it will be. But also in the other side, for example, information security is again linked with the quantum technologies, and also some other parts, which technologies in here, again linked with the quantum technologies. But end of the day, we are asking to the people, I mean, working in, I mean, with different type of parameters in here. I don't know how many parameters, but end of the day, the scientists and technologists are picking up some of the technologies in terms of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So quantum technologies still is not a place in Turkey which we would like to see. So, but how, okay, so this is our approach as TÜBİTAK. So we want to start from the impact, okay, and come to the output, so what we need. And of course, this is a kind of a management of the system. So from the TÜBİTAK side, as I already mentioned, so we have been in one part, we are funding the research for universities, for academia, for industry, for individuals as a fellowship programs and increasing the awareness of science and technology in the society. And in the other side also, I mean, linked with the international collaboration with 60 countries by means of bilateral projects. But also in the other side, we have been our research center and institutes on strategic areas. And as to be talked what we are trying to do, especially starting from year 2018, we are working on more outcome and impact-oriented type of programs, and in and our main goal is qualified knowledge and qualified human resources. So, from the qualified knowledge, is in two way. One is working on the mission-oriented type of programs, and for example, one of them is on quantum information systems. So this is a, I mean, call will be open for 2020. So it's very soon, I mean, in months time. So we will work on technology readiness level from 1 to 6. So which means that we don't see any commercialization at this moment. We want to be more concentrated on basic science and maybe technology development and on the subtopics. So this is, I mean, we have been 154 calls during the period of 2019 and 20. And I mean, quantum information system is, I mean, this call is much relevant from what we are talking in here. So therefore, we are expecting, at least as an outcome of your interest, to come to apply these projects. And in the other one, also we are working on big platform projects. So in that case, our funding mechanism is not only fund the researcher, it's fund the platform, I mean, as a cluster. And the type of areas is a high technology areas, so therefore, again, quantum technologies in somehow has been relevant, both for the technology development part and in the other side, so this is a technology development part by coordinated by the universities, or it is a commercialization part coordinated by the companies. But in any case, the universities, either as a coordinator or partner, and in the case of the also in the other side, maybe they are not the coordinator because it's a commercialization part, but it's definitely a technology provider in so the university is also involved in that platform. So and so therefore this platform will work what type of project is going to be funded. So in the other side, so in the qualified human resources, so in there are different type of programs. TÜBİTAK is running for many years, and more recent ones we have been at two programs. Is one of them is industrial PhD program. So it is, I mean, it's, which we think that, as I said, to increase the number of PhD holders, not only academia and resource centers, also industry. And the program is fund the PhD students and the projects for the 4 years program and plus 3 years during the employment stage, up to the 60% of the salary is funded by TÜBİTAK. So it's a 7-year program, and another one is on international fellowship program for outstanding researchers. So this is for both incoming researchers around the globe, not only limited to the Turkish researcher, lives in abroad. But also we have been prepared, announced a program is called, 2247. It is it is a similar type of ERC type of program. So it is a frontier of research, including the quantum technologies, will be funded for the high level of researchers, and the project will be funded up to 5 million Turkish lira. Will be started in 2020. And from the last 5 years, when I check, as a bottom-up approach, okay, I should say, as a bottom-up approach, it's not a top-down. From the basic science area, so 95, only the 5% are related to the quantum technologies, which, as I said, is not satisfied. So therefore, we have a specific call on quantum technologies, quantum information technologies. Now we have been 10 centers and institutes from TÜBİTAK in 4 cities, and we are in the Gebze campus. And the Institute for Basic Science in here. So the outcome of this workshop and the institute, which I can see personally, is cross-cutting the all institutes. Not at this stage for today. It was just founded again, and limited resources. But I definitely pushing myself and also together with our director, so how we can affect the other institutes. So otherwise, we only be limited to the technology part, but the technology can be only be successful if we have the science. So therefore, the role of this institute is quite critical. So therefore, in future, we will definitely continue to workshops and some other events. And therefore, in that respect, we are also looking forward to your suggestions and also your great contribution. And also, this is from, again, Turkish ecosystem side. So when we, again, check, so what we are doing on quantum, so this is only limited to the Turkey. So what we are doing we are working on the, quantum chemistry. You acknowledge, I only collect the data. So in one side, we have the chemistry, so the quantum chemistry. And in the other side is on semiconductor and the quantum dots, so in one cluster there. And in one on the nonlinear optics. So this is data. I have been asked for in a global or in certain countries, but time was not enough, so I cannot compare with the. But at least you can, scientists and technologists coming from the field, you can say more on them. But so this is the landscape. So finally, as I said, so we see quantum technologies as an emerging technology. Either in a short term or medium or long term. And we need to be more collaboration, but I am said in the at the beginning of my talk as well, more than the collaboration, we need more co-creation. So the co-creation means that we need to use the same infrastructure and human resources, I mean, jointly. So not only, I mean, doing the research, I mean, project in one lab and in the other lab. So we should able to, because the number of our researchers and infrastructure is limited. So therefore, more than the collaboration, the co-creation is one of the key parameter for us, especially for emerging technologies, and quantum technologies is a, one of the emerging technology for us. So once more, I thank you very much for all, I mean, our lecturers, speakers, and I mean, scientists, and also our students. Also, they are spending their time. They can be used for more other occasion, for other purpose, but they come in here and spend the whole 3 and 4 days, including the weekend. And I thank you very much to Ali Kramoja again, so, and looking forward to have the next workshops in near future. So thank you.